"I don't believe it'll be of much use to him any more," said he, "for it's full of pollywogs and fish eggs, and the water has took all the crinkle out of the straw and ruined it. I guess, Trot, that the best thing for us to do is to empty out all his body and carry his head and clothes along the road till we come to a field or a house where we can get some fresh straw."
"Yes, Cap'n," she agreed, "there's nothing else to be done. But how shall we ever find the road to Glinda's palace without the Scarecrow to guide us?"
"That's easy," said the Scarecrow, speaking in a rather feeble but distinct voice. "If Cap'n Bill will carry my head on his shoulders, eyes front, I can tell him which way to go."
So they followed that plan and emptied all the old wet straw out of the Scarecrow's body. Then the sailor man wrung out the clothes and laid them in the sun till they were quite dry. Trot took charge of the head and pressed the wrinkles out of the face as it dried, so that, after a while, the Scarecrow's expression became natural again and as jolly as before. This work consumed some time, but when it was completed, they again started upon their journey. Button Bright carrying the boots and hat, Trot the bundle of clothes, and Cap'n Bill the head. The Scarecrow, having regained his composure, and being now in a good humor, despite his recent mishaps, beguiled their way with stories of the Land of Oz. It was not until the next morning, however, that they found straw with which to restuff the Scarecrow. That evening they came to the same little house they had slept in before, only now it was magically transferred to a new place. The same bountiful supper as before was found smoking hot upon the table, and the same cozy beds were ready for them to sleep in.